Hello friends, we are going to discuss about the binders today and this will be the last topic before we start discussion about the STLs, Standard Template Libraries. So let's see what are the binders and how we can use them. So first thing you need to remember is that binders can only be used with binary functions. First thing is that it can be used with the binary functions. Here I'm going to write a functor, which is a class having an operator overloaded like this. And I have already told you about the functor, so I'm not going to discuss more about it. So this class will act like a functor, and it will take two arguments. The object of this function will take two arguments to get something done, right? So here I'm writing the function, writing the name of the class as getDivision, and it has been inherited from the binary function class. And here it is returning the division of argument 1 divided by argument 2, right? So I have to write this functor, which can be used with the binders. Okay, so if you have to write a functor, or you can say a binary function, right? If you have to write a binary function which can be used with the binders, then in that case you need to remember two things. First thing is that the argument should be constant and the reference should be passed up for the values, right? Both the arguments, they should have been passed with the reference of the values with const, right? You need to pass the constant value reference, and your function should also return a const. This you must need to remember, otherwise you will get errors when you will use these functions, these binary functions, using the binders, right? So this one is the function. Let's see if it works properly or not without the binders. So let's create getDivision. We are going to create an object int, and result can be double. Okay, so here I'm going to write like obj, fobj, function obj. So I'm just creating it, and here I'm going to get a result, double r is equal to fobj, and then I need to pass two values. Since I have to pass the reference, so I need two values which are declared as variables, so that I can pass the reference of these values. So it's 12. First one is k, which is equal to 84, and the second one is l, which is equal to 12. And now we are going to pass 84 and 12, and let us see what will be the output. And that output I need to print here, r. Okay, so let's see what is the output, so that we can test that our functor is working properly. Okay, so 7 comes here. So we are fine with this. Now we are going to use the same function with the binders, right? Same functor we are going to use with the binders. So let's see what the binders do and what it returns and what it and how it is used. So binders are of two types. First binder is like which can bind one of the arguments, first argument to the function, and returns a unary object, unary function. And the second argument, second function is the binder second, bind first, bind second. And there are two more functions, binder first and binder second. So these are the four functions that you need to remember when you are using the binders. So binder first and binder second, these are the two kind of binders. But what does a binder returns? Binder first, you will use the binder first or binder second, and both of these functions returns a unary function object, a unary functor, or you can say a unary function object, a unary function object, or unary predicate, whatever you want to say, depending on the type of value it is returning. And at the same time, when you are using this binder first or binder second, you need to pass the first argument in case you are using the binder first. And if you are using the binder second, then you need to pass the second argument to this function. So if you are passing the second argument or the first argument, then it means that you are binding one of the arguments to the binary function, and you are getting a unary function object. And you can use that unary function object with the remaining argument. Right, it is a bit complicated, it become a bit complicated. So let's see with the help of example that what I am trying to say. Okay, because it's a bit difficult concept when you are using it. Once you use it, once you know that how it is used, you will be able to understand it, and no, you don't need anyone else to explain it to you. Okay, so let's use the binder first. But if you have to use the binder first, binder second, and the binder functions, then first you need to include the header functional. This is the header using which you will be able to use the binders. So binder first. Binder first means I need to bind the first argument to a binary function, right? So how I will do this? So binder first, and here you need to write the name of the function, gate division, and what it take, integer, integer, and double. And then what I need to do, I just need to UObj. This is my object which will be returned. And how it will be returned? You need to call bind first. If you are binding the first argument, then you need to use the function bind first. If you are using binder first, then the return value will come from the bind first only, right? So here what you will do, bind for, inside the bind first, you will call this function get division, and here again you will pass the argument types double, and then you will create an object. You can see that it is expecting a function object, and then it is expecting the left argument, that is the first argument for this binary function, whatever you are going to create, right? Because it is an unnamed functor, and with at the same time it also needs the first argument. So how I will pass the first argument? Again, I need to create two values here. Int k is equal to 84, int l is equal to 12, and then I need to pass first argument, which is the k, right? So I have passed the first argument to this bind first, and inside this UObj, I have now got a unary function. It has been reduced to a unary function. This UObj is a unary function. And if you have to call this unary function, then you can call this unary function with rest of the argument, with remaining argument, which is L. So how I will call this? I am going to get the result of the division inside the M. So double M is equal to, what I will do, UObj, and then what it is expecting the right argument, which was left. So, which was left to be passed, because in the binder first, we have got a unary object by passing the second, by passing the first argument to the bind first. Now I need to pass the second argument to get it completely done. So I am passing the second argument, which is L, and now I am going to display the value of L. The division is what I need to do, M. I need to print M. Now let's see what happens. The division should come out to be 7. The division is 7. So it's working fine. So we have seen that how we can use the binder first. In case you are using the binder second, you don't need to do anything else. You just need to do like this, and you need to pass the second argument, the right argument, the rightmost argument, which is the L. I just want to pass the value of L to the rightmost argument, right? So this is L, and here you need to bind second. You need to call this. So if you are using binder second, then you need to use this bind second function. So once you use the bind second, the second argument has been bound, and you have got a unary function object which can be used with the first argument, which is the k. So here you need to pass the k. So if you will see here, then it is expecting the left argument, which means the first argument. So this will be k. Now again, the output will be same. The division is 7. So I hope you got that how you can use the binder first, binder second, and what is the meaning of the binders. Okay. So let's do some more things like 10 so that I can see the double results as well. So in the double format, result will be returned. It's 8. Okay, 10 to 84. So 8 is there. So this one was the result. So result was of type double. or you can say I can just pass float. Let's see if float is able to give me the correct result. Float. Okay, so return here what I can do, underscore result argument 1 divided by argument 2. This I need to do when I'm doing the division, I think. So now I should see some results. It's again 8. Yes, so it is returning fine, because until you are using this one, it will return only the rounded value. So it will be something like this. So if I do like this, then it should return 8 again. Yeah, it's fine. So it works like that only. Okay, so this is the division operator that is used. Okay, so this is working fine. And this was all for today for binder first and binder second. And we are done with the prerequisites before we start with the STLs, Standard Template Library. So guys, we are ready now to move ahead with the Standard Template Libraries. So stay tuned and be with me. And we will complete all the concepts related to the Standard Template Library. Okay, so from tomorrow onwards, we will start with the Standard Template Libraries. Okay, so have a nice day. Bye-bye, friends. And please like, subscribe my channel and share my videos if you find it useful for your friends as well. So just help me out here to reach to the most of the people. Okay, so have a nice day. Bye-bye. And we will meet soon again today, tomorrow.